And we're going to say the opposite of a sigma bond is a pi bond. Okay. You're going to say a pi bond is sideways overlapping of p orbitals. And we're going to say if you have elements single bonded to each other, you have one sigma. Every bond you make is always a sigma bond. Let's say our compound has two bonds together. It's a double bond. Well, it's going to have one sigma and one pi. And let's say a compound has three bonds, a triple bond. Again, it's going to have one sigma and two pi bonds. Every extra bond you add, that's a pi bond being added. So just remember, here we're talking about the direct overlapping of atomic orbitals. So we're talking about the formation of a bond, a sigma bond. And then we're gonna say if we had a double bond or a triple bond, those would be pi bonds that we're adding on top of the sigma bond. They're kind of like the bread that goes around the meat of the bond. The meat portion would be the sigma bond. The bread part adds extra strength to that sigma bond. Now, what would happen though, if we're trying to form a covalent bond with different atomic orbitals? For example, we have BCl2. Now, BCl2 looks like this. We'll say beryllium is in group 2A, so it has two valence electrons. Chlorine's in group 7A, it has seven. Halogens, when not in the center, only make one bond. But the problem here is, the electron configuration of beryllium is helium, 2s2, and that of chlorine is neon, 3s2, 3p5. And here's the thing, an s and a p cannot mix together. They're different atomic orbitals. They have to both be the same letter for them to successfully mix. This is where hybridization comes into play. Now, hybridization is a way of us mixing our s, our p, and sometimes our d orbitals together to make a hybrid orbital. That hybrid orbital will have a little bit of S character, P character, and D character. That'll allow the central element to form bonds with basically any other element. So what's going to happen here is, for the beryllium to form a bond with the chlorine, it needs to somehow gain a P orbital. So what's going to wind up happening here is, in its 2s electron orbital, we're going to have the promotion of one of its electrons. So this electron here is actually going to get promoted and jump up to the 2p orbital. And as a result, we have now one in the 2s and one in the 2p. And we're gonna say here now, the way it would look visually is like this. And I'm gonna remove myself from the shot guy so we have more room to write stuff. So visually, this is the way it looks. We have our electrons in the 2s, and remember the shape of S is a sphere. We want to promote it to the P, and P looks like a dumbbell, looks like that. What's going to happen, like I said, is this electron is going to jump over here. And what that really means is that this P and this S shape are going to mix together, and they're kind of going to spit out a hybrid baby. This hybrid orbital is going to have a little bit of S character, a little bit of P character. So and as you can notice, it kind of looks like it's a dumbbell, but one side is a lot bigger than the other side. It's a hybrid of these two guys here. These are the parents. This is their offspring. And because we promoted one electron to the 2p region, we're going to say that this becomes an sp hybrid orbital because it has one that's in the s and one that went to the p. That's why it's called sp. But remember, P has how many electron orbitals? P has three electron orbitals. We only had enough electrons to place them in one of them. So these two over here are not being utilized. We would say that those two electrons here, those two electron orbitals, are called our unhybridized orbitals. This is the way bonds form. If the atomic orbitals are different letters, they cannot mix together. So to get around this, we're going to mix up those orbitals together. forming hybrid orbitals. Since this now is has S and P characteristics, it can form a bond with chlorine, because chlorine wants something with P characteristics involved. Since it's a hybrid, it does have some P characteristics involved. So that's why we're able to do this. Now, hybridization is a little conceptual, really conceptual, but just remember the basics of this. When it comes to answering questions, which we're going to do next, it is really easy and simple to follow as long as you look at it in a very simple way. So just get down the fundamentals of this. In order for different atomic orbitals, different letters to connect together, we have to mix and hybridize the atomic orbitals of the central element. And in that way, we can form bonds.